Hello everybody and welcome back to Subnautica, where today I did go back to the Aurora and do some stuff that I didn't actually fully complete, like getting the pieces to the Cyclops. There was one more that was easily accessible that I didn't grab. As well, I found the PDA, but okay, apparently I do not make the Cyclops right there? Wait a second, I got the Cyclops. Welcome, I got all of the pieces. Did I not? I did look at the Peeper. And the Bladderfish. Oh, there's four pieces of the Prawn. Well, I guess that's what we're doing. We're heading back
Welcome aboard, Captain.
Go get the final piece wherever the final piece may be. We need to go this away. And we will go into the lower hatch, as that is the best way to get to the Prawn area quickly. There's one of the whales. You can see parts of the Aurora on the right, just glowing in the darkness. But yeah, so I thought I got all the Prawn pieces, but But yeah, so that's what we'll be making, and we'll be using that to get around eventually in terms of getting some of the stuff. But we actually need to go around and find any and all wreckages again, too, to see which ones require welding points and not whatnot, so that we can get some of that. Okay, park it right there. And let's go. We can get in right here. Just like that. Let's get in this puppy and figure out where or what we missed. I said no, put it away. So, yeah, like I said, I got into the lab right there, so. Ow. Ow. Where's the exit? That's right, and then we gotta swim through the bowels of the ship. Come on. Get through there. Okay, so another one of these Prawn pieces is scannable. Don't tell me it's that one, because I put my fire extinguishers away. No, it's not that. Then where is the last Prawn piece? And I got all the fire extinguishers out of this place, so. If anything, that is it. I'm gonna have to put out that fire, which I have no, okay. Well, this is just all buggered today. Yeah, let me pause it right here and I'll bring you guys back once I have found, or once I have gotten my fire extinguisher and have gotten back to get the Prawn out. So I will see you guys then. Okay, and we're back. Let's use up the one that is almost out first. And just put out all these fires, so that I can scan this. Ooh, just enough. Or maybe not, because its head is on fire. Oh, maybe not. Okay. So we got the Prawn suit. Let's GTFO. Get back to the vehicle construction, or the mobile construction bay. And we will... I'm learning the layout at this place pretty well. Ow. Pretty well, but I can't avoid the damage all the time. Oh, and this isn't even on. There we go. Ah, come on, through the door. I did not know that that would clip me. Just across, and we will head back. Get the Prawn suit. Now, what is needed is just a few more base materials. We need the moon bay. We need a bigger habitat structure than just the tubes for the base. And such. And the base will get a small redesign to try to fit everything around. Because what I'm planning on doing is... The reason why I have the second level on shallow base is I'm going to put the moon pool up on that. And I'm going to build... A second side to the base, in which then I will get rid of all of the tube base stuff and replace that with proper habitat pieces. Actually, we don't need to build the base right now. Let's go hunting for some of those wreckages. Yes? That's just coral. I was about to say it's scrap, but it clearly isn't. Here's a wreckage, but nothing inside. Oh gosh. Loading new area. Laggy. Is that some wreckage? No, it's just cut out terrain. Oop, that's wreckage. I do believe this is wreckage that we may have not been fully able to explore, because that door back there needs to be cut. What are those? Oh. I do believe those are something similar to piranha based on their teeth. Well, that is... Oh. Not going to be very good. And there's an openable hatch right there. Yeah, see, they're attacking the pod. And there's no way for me to hurt them while in here. Well, actually, the better point is that there's no way to... Ooh, this is new altogether. Oh, hello. Sand shark. Because there are... stuff I have not opened around it. Let's see if there's any parts outside real quick. And then we will head into it. Does not seem like there are any parts outside of it. Oop. What did I hit? One of the bigger fish probably. Ooh, is this like secret entrance? Going in 007 style? Let's try it. Because this seems clearer than the other side. Get our knife out, just in preparations. That's scannable. A picture frame. Anything in here? Come on, open up. There is, but I'm gonna need air, so. So So let's get some air real quick. And I know this is the dangerous side. Oh, ooh, wow. We're actually pretty deep. Actually, going around, back around to the sea moth probably would have been just as effective. But I wanted to stay on this side. Oop, come on. Go, 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 go. Okay, now let's see what's in here. That picture is everywhere. That's the only picture that there is, I swear. Laser cutter. And let's open this puppy up. But yeah, there's a chest outside too. So that's how I know that I haven't necessarily been here. Or if I have, I just cherry picked it. Oh gosh, I'm running out of air. You know what? I'll explore it after I get the sea moth back around to this side of the ship. Because... come on, can I go faster? Please? Okay, I have to just get away from the ship for a second.
Emergency. 10 seconds of oxygen remaining.
Yes, I know. I know. 10 seconds of oxygen. Captain. And those things are just being a butt. Okay, I have noticed something too, that I get out the side of the sea moth. So if I just come in here and twist it like that. Okay, that did not quite work how I wanted it to, but eh, good enough. Ooh, that's an accessible door. Ooh, and what are you? A light stick? It's a light stick. Nothing right there, but there's this hatch. Whoa, how big is this place? Anything up? Nope. So let's go down. Oh my. I will need air though. Here soon. The Prawn torpedo arm. Obviously there's going to be more than one, but let's head back, get air.
30 seconds of oxygen remaining.
And then we'll be back down there to see if there's anything else that we can see. Got the air. Get out. Let's get back down there. Do I actually swim any faster? No, I don't. So that's just a waste of, then again, I do have the flippers, so. Let's see what else is down here, because there must be the other arm somewhere down here. Nope. Maybe with the propulsion cannon. We need to, get rid of that one, some beams. To, be able to open this door. Because these beams might be movable.
30 seconds of oxygen remaining.
Okay, let's, get some air real quick. But we got a one piece of the torpedo arm, so that will be able to show those fishies whatnot. But this door is accessible, or it says it is. Can I open you? No. Okay, never mind. I guess not. Well, we got one torpedo arm, and I do feel like I explored this portion as much as I could. Let's see if there is any other section. No, that's where I was looking out when I was in the bottom of the ship, so I don't think that there actually is any other section to this piece. There's the entrance down there, but that didn't really go anywhere. Yeah, so that's kind of sad. There's only one, piece of the torpedo arm out here. Oh, that's the thing that shoots at me. I don't want to go in there. Oops. Wrong button. I was trying to see if there was like a up or... oh, there is a down. Which one's up then? Oh, simply up, down. Okay. Now that I know those maneuver pieces. Yeah, nothing in there. Okay. So let's move on. Okay, the base is over there, so we'll keep on going at a 90 to it. The daylight is fading. There's not going to be anything in the kelp forest, I know that, so let's not head into there. We are getting a little thirsty. Let's drink some of our reclaimed water. And we do have that nutrient block on us, so we don't have to worry. Actually, did I? Yeah, I packed some water with me. Okay, good, good, good. That's right. The forest. Why am I always here at night? Anywho, let's see if there's any bigger wreckage. Let's go to the very edge of this. Ooh, that's right. This was at the very limit of that the sea moth could go down. Let's just hope there's no Leviathan out here. This is a big open area. There's no opening on this side, which is terrible.
Caution, passing safe depth. Warning, maximum depth reached.
What was that coming out the bottom? Okay. So we have openings over here. Okay, it looks like an opening right here. So let's pull up to it and jump out. Scanner at the ready. Floodlight. Wouldn't necessarily be bad. Could put them outside to illuminate the base. Modification station fragment. I think I already have that, right? No. Okay. So. A door. Here we go. And open. Modification station fragment. We are almost out of air, too, so we need to start heading back. And there's the out. There's a hatch right there, so we'll take that next time because it looked like the other direction didn't actually go anywhere. Can get a little closer with the sea moth. Scanner at the ready. That looks like an openable thing. But maybe not. Oh wow, this is like really deep into this piece. This is definitely a new area than what I've... there we go, the modification station. But the thing is I need to pretty much immediately go back. Ooh, the indoor grow bed. I need that for stuff. Now I need to head back something fierce because it took almost my full breath to get through here. Oh god. Red herring. Okay. Stop. This way. Oh gosh, this is gonna be close. It's gonna be really close. 2, 1. Starting to black out. Where's the exit? Oh god, nope, I'm dead. Damn it.
Welcome aboard, Captain.
Well, time to go get the sea moth. That's gonna be one hell of a dive, too. Even with the sea glide. So, Because I'm going to have to go just straight down from on top of it to be able to reach it before running out of breath, I'm guessing. Because that is really, really deep. I have to replace the battery here in just a second. But damn. We needed that grow bed too, though, so... put another battery in you, get some air. Keep going this way, because we were pretty far out. It's starting to get below us. Just a little closer. Actually, you could see the wreckage from up here. Okay, that is straight down. So, we're near straight down. I do not appreciate the spooky music. Do not appreciate the spooky music. Oh, wow, what is that? Okay, I did not see that before.
Welcome aboard, Captain.
Okay, but it looked like we got everything from there. Correct? That we... Torpedo arm. We still need the other Cyclops engine piece. Yep, nothing is on there, but it is down here, right? Yes, okay, the indoor grow bed. Swim charge fins. Wirelessly charge your held tools while you... I like that. Increase swim speed. I think the charging of the tools, though. High capacity tank. I need that. That is what I need. Okay, so when we get back, that is what we're going to craft. Extra light tank? I don't know about that. Thermoblade. I do want that. Hardened blade. I do not have a diamond. Because I want a blade that just doesn't die anymore. So, yes, I do want that. Okay, so... And I'm guessing I have to make these from this. So that's hence why I got all of those afterwards. Ooh. Anyways, how are we doing on time? Yeah, we're doing okay. Not the best, but we're doing okay. Yeah, let's head this way. Kind of start arcing towards home. Kind of try to always keep it at the 45. That way we're kind of traveling towards it. Oh, wait. That's right. There's a Leviathan around here. Oh, God. There he is. Ha, ha, ha. That's scary. Okay. So, let's try to keep it kind of in the view. We'll see if we can't run into anything. More kelp forest. Once you get the sea moth, the world actually becomes a lot smaller. That there doesn't seem to be as much stuff. Oh, that's right. While I was gathering stuff too, I did find the rescue pod 3, which had a PDA in it that did nothing. Speak of which, is this rescue pod 3? I think this might be rescue pod 3. Yeah, see. Oh, as well, you cannot kill those things with a survival knife. I did try. It was stuck, so I was like, I'll take my chance. and it stopped bleeding after a while, and it could still hurt me. So, yeah, that's not how you get a stalker tooth. So, if you're looking to get your enameled glass. Okay, and it looks like we're almost back to base. Back at base, bugs in the software, flash the message, something's out there, floating in the summer sky. I'll stop right there, so, I spare people my singing. I think I'm half decent, like, I'm not professional worthy by any means, but I'm not, like, the worst. And down. Our newly learned controls. Yes. Okay. Get wow. Put me out behind it. Why don't you? Alrighty. So let's see what it takes to make this modification station. The floodlight, which will allow us to illuminate stuff quite nicely. Miscellaneous, our picture frame. Interior modules. Really? It's like in the same place as the grow bed? And the plant pot? That means I might be able to grow stuff out of it. Huh. We'll see what we can do with that then. Okay, so we need a wiring kit and a computer chip and 2 titanium. So that means we need 3 silver. 1, 2, 3 silver. We need... stop it. I do believe we need 2 quartz. What was it? 2 quartz. We need some table coral. Let's get our survival knife. And that makes sense why you keep your survival... Why do I keep on trying to say survival? But that's why you keep your survival knife even when it hits 0, is that you can use it to... Now, where did the other one go? Is that you could use it to upgrade to a thermal blade. Or the plasteel. Or no, the diamond edge? I forget what the name of it's called, but... Anywho... but if we have everything electric-based, and then we have the electric flippers, oh my god, it's gonna be so good. Okay, let's see here, electronics, we need a wiring kit. And a computer. Okay, and what else did we need for this? Just 2 titanium, so let's head over to the titanium cabinet. Did we have any extra titanium? No, we didn't. Actually, I think we have some extra quartz. Ooh, speak of which, I grabbed too many. 2 titanium. And we want this. How big is it? It's not terribly huge. We can put it right here up against the window. Just right there. And ta-da. Now, what can we do with you? All we need is a battery. Well, let's see here. We need some lithium and an O2 tank. So we want the high capacity. So 2 titanium and then de-equip our tank. We need a wiring kit for these charge swims. We have the repulsion cannon. Seamoth upgrades. Ooh, pressure compensator. Mark 2, we need a normal pressure compensator, which I'm not quite sure. Is that something we can make in this? Ooh, a light stick. Deployable battery-powered light. But it'd probably be an equipment. Do we have a pressure compensator? We do not. How do we... Yeah, it... How are we supposed to make it if we can't even make the normal pressure compensator? So that's weird. I do find that completely weird. Okay, so we need a wiring kit, we need 2 titanium, and we need a battery. So, let's grab that. So we need 2 titanium. We need a... No, not that one. This one. This one. We need a wiring kit. And we need a battery, which we have. So let's make that wiring kit. Oops. Excuse me. Hiccuping. Okay. And let's make some cool stuff. So let's make the thermal blade. Let's make the... Ooh, I forgot. I have to take this off of me. So let's make the high capacity tank, which will be so nice. It means we'll be able to explore stuff a little bit better. Oh, that's right. And I gotta probably de-equip the fins too, yes? And the charge swim fins. So yeah, now we have some actually pretty cool gear on us now. We do have some batteries to swap out, as well as a new one to need to make to get back up to normal, I would think. Maybe not, because we can have 4 on us and there's 3 in there at the moment. So actually we're pretty good. Drink, eat. And we are back up to 100% almost. But I think that will be it for this episode. Ooh. It doesn't have a power gauge, though. Which bothers me. Because... Oh, it still has a durability? That's not cool. That's not cool at all. I thought this was just going to be battery charged. But yeah, now we have up to 105 seconds of air, which is really, really nice. We have, well, let's pull out something. We have fins of which charge, oh wow, see, it's already going up. Just swim around out here. That charges the batteries on all of our stuff. I wonder if when nothing's out, it actually charges the batteries in our inventory, because that would be cool. As well as, oh yeah, I already showed off the heated blade. So, but anywho, that will be it for this episode. Next time we will go back out searching for more goodies. And I find it funny that that is still giving off bubbles as if we're underwater. Oh dear. They need a phase switch for the knife. But anywho, thank you guys for watching. If you liked the episode, please do leave a like. We did find that Prawn torpedo arm, which was freaking awesome, but there was only one piece there, so we do have to find the other one. But do subscribe if you're not already to catch the next episode as it comes out, as we will be looking for a lot more tech, because we want to improve our base, expand it out a bit, so that we can prep ourselves for going even deeper. We need to find that pressure compensator too. Anyways, if you have any comments, questions, or suggestions, please leave those in the comment section below, and I will see you guys next time. Thank you for watching, and have a good one. Goodbye.